a recalibrate thermostat. Now this is a thermostat which we've taken out of the little box. Now this is a copy of the Renko thermostat. Now I've got a Renko thermostat box here, and on the box it's got some specifications. It says cold out minus 26, constant in plus 3.5, warm out minus 11. What that means is cold out means if you turn your thermostat to maximum temperature, it will break contact on these two little screws where your sensor is mounted at minus 26. Warm out means if you turn it to its warmest position, it will switch the motor off on this setting, on these two screws at minus 11. And warm in, constant in, means once the motor is switched off, this plate will defrost, the ice will melt off this plate, and normally by 3.5 all the ice is melted and it restarts again. So we refer to this as cycle defrost. Now this difference, minus 26 to minus 11, is quite a big difference. What we find when this plate gets to about minus 18 degrees, the temperature in the fridge is about plus 4, which is a perfect temperature, which is smack bang in the middle of that. But every now and then we find there's a problem with the settings and we can recalibrate this. Now if you have a look, there's two little adjusting screws there. Now the one that's deeper in on the left hand side there, that will alter on what they refer to as the cold out. So by rotating clockwise on this screw, you're going to make that minus 26, 27, 28 or colder, depends how much you turn, and the opposite way. Now this particular one actually affects both of them, but on this particular one, this motor starts up before it's defrosted, so we need to give it a longer defrost. So in other words, this 3.5 we must make warmer to about 4 or 5 degrees, and how we do that is by rotating this screw clockwise. So I'm going to give it a half a turn clockwise. Once we've turned on that screw, this will probably be not plus 3.5 anymore, it will be plus 4 or 5. We don't know how far we've gone, but now we've affected that, those two, and we can counter that by turning this one in anti-clockwise. But first what we're going to do is we're going to run it with a thermometer, see the temperatures, and if need be we'll do more calibrations.
Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up, and if you'd like to see more videos, subscribe to our channel.